We have only one life to live, and we do not know when this earthly life will come to an end. We must therefore think of living this only one life that we have the best we can, living the life that is pleasing to God, and living the life that will be a blessing for other people. Are you living your life in its fullness? Are you living your life with purpose? Are you satisfied with the life that you live now? In your life's journey, at the end of your life, will you be able to say, looking back, that, oh, I have lived my life with my best. I'm satisfied with the life that I have lived. Will you be able to say? Will God be pleased with the life that you live here on earth? What is the most excellent way to live our lives? What is the best way that we can live our lives here on earth? The Bible teaches us the best way to live our lives. It says, I will show you the most excellent way. Now, what is that most excellent way that the Bible talks about? What is the best way that we can live that the Bible teaches us? That is the way of love. I want to tell you, when we live our lives with love, that is the best way that we can ever live our lives. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1 to 8, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing. Now you must know this fact, that all the gifts and the services, including our service and devotion to God and our service to other human beings and the good works that we do to help other people, will be of no value without love. The words that are spoken without love, the sacrifice that is made without love, and the works that are done without love have no value at all. You know, our talents, our abilities, and the experience that we have, and the good works that we have, will have no value in the sight of God if those things are done without love. The things that we do, the service that we do, the worship that we give to God, and the devotion that we do to God, and the help that we extend to other people must come out of love for God and out of love for human beings. The most excellent way to live a life for human being is the way of love, to love God and to love other human beings. Now, what is love? The Bible teaches us that love is patient and kind. It does not envy or boast. It is not proud or rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. And it always perseveres. And love never fails. You know, the greatest thing all over the other things for human is love. The greatest need for human is love. People need to be loved. The most excellent way to live your life is the way of love. We must walk in the way of love, and we must show love to everyone. Jesus said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your strength. And he goes on to say, love your neighbor as yourself. The Bible teaches us to love God with our whole heart, mind, and strength. And the Bible also teaches us to love other people just as we love ourselves. Love God because He is the one who created you. He is the one who sustains your life. Love other human beings because they are your family members in a greater family of God. We must know this thing, my brothers and sisters. For God, as Father of all human beings are just one big family. We are part of that family. You are member and I am member to that great family of God. When I love other human beings, it simply means that I love my family members. God loves everyone. He loves them all. And therefore, we must also love everyone. Beloved, as children of God, we cannot be so selective in loving other people. We cannot just choose some people to love and choose some people to hate. Our love must include everyone. The best way to learn how to love other people is from the life of Jesus Christ, who gave His life for the salvation of human beings. He loves all human beings, whether rich or poor, righteous or unrighteous. He loved the sinners. He forgave their sins. He forgave our sins and He gives us salvation. He manifested His love until the last breath of His life. He died for the sins of the world. We are His children. We are His disciples. We must do the same. When you receive Jesus Christ into your heart, and when you follow His footsteps, you will not find difficult to love other people. You'll be able to lead the most excellent way of life. That is the way of love. And you will not find difficult to love other people. You know, when you experience God's love in your heart, in your life, you cannot just sit in one place, but you will find every opportunity where you can express the love that you have, the love of God that is working in your heart, and you will be the agents of God's love for other human beings. You will be the agent of transforming the lives of many people by showing God's love to them. You will be a channel of blessing for other people. Beloved, God loves you and God wants to bless you. God wants to use you as a channel of blessing for other people. How that can happen? Listen, when you lead your life in the most excellent way, that is the way of love. When you live your life to love God with your whole heart and with your whole strength and mind, and when you love other people just as God loves them. Today, ask the Lord to help you receive His great love. And ask the Lord to give you power to express that great love through your life and through your actions. I want to tell you, you can be a blessing for other people. God's blessing will flow through you when you obey Him, when you can live your life in the most excellent way, when you can live your life with the purpose of showing love to other people. God will use you. May the Almighty God bless you to live the most excellent way, the way of love, and be a blessing for many people.